From the power grid to major corporations, no one anywhere in the world is immune to cyber attacks. And the problem is growing.
The internet is becoming more and more integrated into our lives every single day. And we as citizens and we as corporations and governments are becoming more interconnected and using the internet as part of that backbone of communication and collaboration. This means that there's increased attack surface for those who wish
more dependence and digital information on the web means greater financial gain for criminals. In the last year, there has been an increase in cases of ransomware.
It's becoming easier and easier in part because the toolkits needed to break into many of these systems are becoming more readily accessible on the dark web.
So ransomware is an epidemic right now. And part of the reason is, from the cyber criminals' perspective, it's a great business. And what I mean by that is, if you think about a cyber criminal stealing data, there's two problems with stealing data. Number one, the data often loses value very quickly. If you steal credit cards, as soon as the bank cancels them, that data set no longer has value. The other problem is you have to digitally fence the information, and everybody in the pipeline takes a cut. With ransomware, you don't have those problems. You're essentially extorting dollars directly from your victim into your pocket, so it's a very profitable capability that cyber criminals have moved to, and we're seeing it all over the map.
Tracking down the criminals is not easy.
We do think that reporting cyber intrusions is underreported to law enforcement, whether it's the FBI, Secret Service, or another entity. I think it's a business decision, the concern about the publicity.
The FBI says the people doing the hacking range from criminals who want money to hackers with geopolitical motivations.
Clearly, there are nation states that are involved in cyber activity and who are interested in stealing our trade secrets, our proprietary information that our companies are developing, our secrets within our government.
Most cyber attacks require multiple weaknesses or vulnerabilities of some form in order to be able to reach the final goal of the attacker. One of the greatest weaknesses of any corporate network is the human element.
Julian Christopher Crenshaw, VOA News, Washington.